Greetings from Heartcare Foundation of India and eMedi News. Welcome to our show, Chat with Dr. KK. We have with us Dr. Sanjay Gupta. He is a senior orthopedic surgeon at Moolchand Med City and one of an expert in joint replacement. Let's concentrate on when we talk about joint replacement. There was an era people used to be afraid.
Jee.
This was pre-Atal Bihari Vajpayee
That's
era.
Right. That's right.
And then he got his joint replacement done.
That's right.
People have to call a surgeon from outside, and after that, there's no girth of joint replacement. Every hospital now is doing a joint replacement. So first of all, let's remove the myth from the mind of the people. People feel it's a joint replacement. When you talk about liver transplant, that liver is changed.
That's
kidney
right.
transplant, new kidney is put.
That's
and we know in joint, there's no joint put. What exactly is joint replacement?
So essentially, yeah, as you rightly mentioned, there is a lot of myth about joint replacement. As in joint replacement surgery, it's not something as in wherein the whole knee is taken out and a new knee is put in. It's not like that. The correct terminology would be resurfacing of the joint, wherein the ends of the bones which are actually making the joints are cut by very fine saw in a shape as to have a cap at the end of the bone. So it's basically capping of the end of the bones and replacing the cartilage of the bone which is damaged. So
it's something like you have a door, ek hisse mein jang lag gaya hai, us hisse ko nikal ke badal diya.
That's
door
right.
remains the same.
That's right.
That's
it's just
it
a capping. The
capping.
Cartilage which is worn out is replaced by metal, and then there is a special articular surface which we call as
okay. Some people say that you need a computerized surgery.
That's right.
So that the surfacing is even.
Jee.
Is it true?
Jee. No, you don't need a computerized. There was an era, say about 5-6 years ago, 10 years ago, wherein computer navigated knee replacement surgeries were very popular, and recently there has been a trend that basically it's about preciseness, and now there are jigs available wherein you can do an MRI scan of the knee and make the jigs. You can order the jigs 6 weeks in advance, so you get the same preciseness with those jigs made with the help of MRI scan as with the computer navigated knee. And the downside of a computer navigation knee is you need a big setup. It's very expensive, and it does consume time until unless somebody who is doing it on a daily basis for number of years.
Now, this is another perception in people's mind that once you do a joint replacement, it won't only lasts for 4 to 5 years.
Jee. No, that's wrong.
Effect.
No, that's wrong. Nicely, if you look at the NICE guidelines, the acceptance rate of a joint replacement is 10% failure in 10 years. So that is something which NICE, which is national guidelines from UK. So that is a survival of a joint, 90% should survive for at least 10 years. But generally speaking, in Western population, because they are very active, their physical demands are more, the joint would last for about say 15 years is normal life expectancy of a normal person, a joint which has been done nicely. But in Indian subpopulation wherein the physical demands are not that high, the joint would last for as good as 15, something between 15 to 20 years if it is properly done, nicely done.
Do you feel that if you reduce weight before joint replacement, the life will be longer of the joint?
That's absolutely right. The life of a joint would be longer if you reduce weight. It helps. If you don't have a joint replacement surgery, even then reducing weight is going to help, because the amount of load, stress you are putting on the joint itself is reduced. But having said that, it's a vicious cycle, because if you tell somebody who has got a completely worn out joint is unable to mobilize, unable to walk, and if you ask them to reduce weight, they can't walk, they can't reduce weight. Huh?
Okay. Even so, in any way, once you done the joint replacement, at least at that time they can start reducing weight.
That's right. And actually, honestly speaking, once they have had a joint replacement surgery, a successful joint replacement surgery, and they are pain free, their quality of life becomes so good, they start walking, they manage to reduce weight, and they prolong the longevity of the joint.
Sometimes we don't replace the joint, we only replace half of the joint.
Partial replacement. This is again another technique wherein in a joint replacement surgery, we cut about 9 to 10 millimeters of the ends of the bones. And in a partial resurfacing surgery, we cut only about 3 to 4 millimeters of the ends of the bone. So it's a bone preserving surgery. It's done with a smaller incision, and it's only applicable wherein the total joint is not replaced, or part of the joint. So in a joint, there are three different parts.
I have two patients.
Jee.
One patient says when I climb stairs, it pains.
Jee.
The second one says when I climb down, it pains. What is the difference?
Jee. The one who says when I climb down it pains has got a patellofemoral, which is the kneecap right at the front of the knee, which is worn out. and which would indicate that the person has a tricompartmental arthritis and would need, you know, a full form of a complete joint replacement surgery. The one who says that when I go up, I have a pain, it depends on the age of the patient as well. One, somebody can have a meniscal problem which can give rise to that kind of pain, or somebody who has got tibiofemoral arthritis, which is arthritis between the thigh bone and the shin bone. That causes pain when you're going up the stairs.
So therefore, it is very important to know whether it is going up or going down.
That's right.
And if it is both?
If it is both, then the person has got both form, all three compartments are worn out, so we get information.
If a person's surgery is done, what are the chances of getting infection?
In a joint replacement surgery, the chances of infection are approximately about 1%. So 1 out of 100 would get an infection.
That's not a big, small rate, that's a big rate.
Yeah, but this is internationally accepted rate. But having said that, one has to go into the details of it, because 1% chances of infection is superficial infection. And if picked up early, the superficial infection can be treated.
What are the chances of death during surgery?
One in 10,000 knee replacement surgeries.
One in 10,000 knee replacement, and they would die of what?
They would die of complications of knee replacement surgery, post-op morbidity, rather than the procedure. So there is no intraoperative death. It's usually post-operative. They would die from DVT, deep vein thrombosis, or pulmonary embolism as a sequelae.
So what Sanjay talks about reminds me of a report from Los Angeles. There was a time when there was a medical doctor's strike, and it lasted for two months. And every day, the mortality reduces. Less number of people died during those 2 months. Does it mean that medical science is responsible for that mortality? The answer is no. To improve your morbidity always will be at the cost of mortality. Either you stay with your joints, get bedridden. If you have a heart attack, just get bedridden in your room, confine it to your room. If you want quality, it will always be expense of some increase in mortality. That means for 10,000 people, if they want to run after having osteoarthritis, you will have to lose one life. And that's what we talk about it. Reducing morbidity always at the expense of reasonable mortality. Let's thank Sanjay to be here with us. And that's all for today. We'll come back with one more show. Till that, goodbye. Thank you.